Hello and welcome, my dear students. I am Rohan sir from Maithi English Medium School. My heartily welcome to all my dear third standard students once again in science lecture. My dear students, I hope that you have watched both the parts of my science lecture, part 1 and part 2 of my science lecture, which was previous to this lecture. So I hope you have watched that lecture very carefully, in which I have completed the explanation of all new chapter number 6, which I just started before 2 days. So, and I also hope that at the same time you have written everything whatever I asked you, and even you have repeated after me the different points of living thing and non-living thing whenever you are asked to do so. Yes, my dear students, I am getting the updates from your follow-up teachers that how many students are sending the work, how many students are not sending, or if you are sending, how much work you are sending, how your handwriting are, and etc., etc. So each and every detail I am getting for the students who are sending the work. So my one humble request to all the students who are watching the lecture but are not sending the work for some or the other reason, I just request you to please take a time of 5 to 10 seconds just to click the photo and send it to your follow-up teachers. If you don't know who is the follow-up teacher, you can even send it to me. So I hope that now onwards you are going to regularly send your work. Also, don't fail to find the new thoughts and send it to me in my WhatsApp so that I can display those thoughts, I can share those thoughts with your friends, and I can even display your name. I hope that you are going to cope up with this format. So in the yesterday's lecture, I just completed the explanation of chapter number 6, living thing and non-living thing. Now I was about to solve few objectives, but there was no time yesterday. In the limited time I have just completed the explanation. Now what are we going to do today is, I will again just give the brief explanation of each and every heading, then we will just repeat the keywords. And you know that daily what you watch in the television, you are able to repeat that easily, you are able to remember that easily. For example, if you watch certain advertisement in the television daily, you are able to then remember it on the tip of your tongue. So this is what my motto is. So now in today's lecture, I'm going to again just brief you out each and every topic, not in detail, just brief you out, and then we are going to repeat few keywords, and then we will solve certain objectives from our textbook itself. I hope you are ready for that. So please just be ready with your rough notebook and with your textbook. And like I said, daily I tell you that those who don't have textbook, they don't have to worry, they just have to wait for the textbook. Till then, they can do their work in the rough notebook. Because I give you the options every time when I ask you to write it down, I give you the options every time that how you can write if you are writing in the rough book. Okay, now I hope you are ready with your textbooks and rough notebooks. So let's get started with the revision briefing out of chapter number 6. My dear students, this is chapter number 6 for those who have not watched either of the two parts. That means few are such students, they have not watched the first part, or few have not watched the second part. For them, okay, I cannot explain in detail again, but I am going to brief the chapter out, so that the ones who have missed the chapter, they can cover the chapter in brief in this lecture. So please make sure you take the benefit of this lecture, you try to understand the topic again and again. If you will listen to me again and again, if you will try to understand it again and again, you will be able to remember the topic very easily. And then during the time of learning, you just have to read the things twice and that's it. So this is chapter number 6, living and non-living things, which we have done. So In this chapter, we are going to discuss all the aspects of living and non-living things, even their characteristics and their different points. So, let's get started. Now, in the original part 1 lecture, when we were just solving chapter 6, we even solved this picture where you have to just label living and non-living things present in the picture. This is what I am not going to do again, because this is just a warm-up exercise which we are not supposed to do in our revision explanation. So, my dear students, then after living things and non-living things, all the animals and plants are living things. Human beings are also living things. Living things move, grow, breathe, need food, feel changes and reproduce. So, these are the characteristics of living beings, that they move, they grow, they breathe, they need food, they feel changes and they reproduce. So, these aspects we are going to discuss throughout the chapter. How they grow, how they move, how they breathe, how they need food, how they feel changes and reproduce. So, these are the main topics we are going to discuss throughout the chapter. Now, here you can see that the first topic is living things move. So, different living things move in a different way. Every living things have their own movement. Here, living things can move on their own. Animals move from one place to another in search of the food and shelter. Now you can see the picture of the bird. Correct? Here, wings are labeled. A bird moves with the help of wings to show that the bird moves with the help of wings. See, usually they have the legs, but they don't walk much. They just fly from one place to another, from one terrace to another, from one tree to another, and across the forests of the world. So, this is how the birds travel using their wings. Animals, dogs, cats, and human beings walk with the help of their legs. Birds and bees also fly with the help of wings. So, like I said, fish moves with the help of the fins. Now, here in the picture you can see that fish is shown to you, and I know that every student has seen fish in their life at least once, either on the television or live. Some of the houses even have aquarium, that is fish tank. So, you can see fish, how they move using their fins. They don't have legs or hands, do they have? No, they don't have, obviously. And students, let me share you one small thing which will amaze you. If you have heard about the dolphins, yes, dolphins are also the kind of fish. They are one of the species of the fish. There are shark, whales, catfish and starfish and etc. etc. Similarly, dolphins are also the fish, and they are said to be more intelligent and intellectual than the human beings. Yes, human beings at an average, human beings have not even used 0.1% of their mind, whereas dolphins are said to have used at least more than 3% of their mind. So, just imagine how intelligent dolphins are. But like God made her inside the water, so they cannot do the inventions like the human beings are doing. So, every animal, even the human beings are the animals, they are the social animals. So, they have kind of legs to walk, fishes have fins to move, birds have wings to move, even the butterflies, bees, different birds have the wings, and they are made according to their lifestyle. Like we walk on the path, we walk on the floor. We don't walk in the water. We can swim in the water using the hands and legs. So, in the same way, fishes tend to live inside the water. That is why they are given fins. Birds tend to live on the trees. That is why they are given the wings. And so on. About the plants, plants do not move from place to place because they do not have to look for the food. Green plants make their own food. Some plants move in the special way. For example, leaves of mimosa, that is touch me not plant, close when touched, thus plants show movement. See, particularly, plants cannot move from one place to another like human beings, animals and birds, because we just sow the seeds at one place. So plants grow, as plants grow their roots get deeper inside the soil, so it is fixed at the one place. So plants cannot move, plants, trees, herbs, shrubs, whatever, they cannot move, but they have the movement. Movement as in, I am not telling the movement that when the air comes they move, they dance, no, they have even the many different kind of movement. Like I said that mimosa, it is a plant, if you can see in this picture, if you touch this plant, it closes its leaves and for the few seconds and then again opens it. So this is what you need to experience. Yes, I have personally experienced. Have you experienced? If no, then please try to find mimosa plant and touch it. You will really enjoy it when you will see it practically with your eyes. So this is an example shown to you to depict that plants even have the different movements. Not only that, but every different plant have the different movement. Moving on to next. Here the point is written very clearly that non-living things such as books, toys and chairs do not move on their own. They move only when someone moves them. Obviously now students, when you come to school, you bring your bag, you wear your shoes, you wear your clothes. So these all are non-living things. When you carry it, when you wear it, only then will you be able to carry it with you. They cannot move on their own. Just imagine, shoes, pair of shoes moving on their own. It is not possible unless you are watching any horror movie, isn't it? Okay, jokes apart, coming back to the topic, non-living things cannot move on their own. Now here you can see the picture of a child playing with a car. Obviously when a child moves the car, when he pushes the car, only then it will move, as it is a toy car. Okay, moving on to the next topic, living things grow. Plants and animals grow in time. Now this picture depicts how human beings grow and how the plants grow. It is just the stages are depicted with a very easy graph, very easy pictorial graph. So baby turns to a kind of teenage, and then it turns to a kind of adult age, or we can say that aged. So slowly they grow, gradually they grow with the age, height and different aspects. Same way even the plants grow. So this is depicted with the picture how living things grow. Then here it is written that non-living things do not grow. Obviously, like I said in the first two parts of the lecture, that water bottle, your school bag, your mobile phone, do they grow? No, they don't grow. They obviously they expire. That means they have the expiry date. You cannot use more than some period of time because it is damaged. So they are damaged, but they do not grow. Living things breathe. This is what I explained after that topic. All the living things need air to breathe. We breathe through our nose. Several other animals breathe through their noses too. Cockroaches, butterflies and mosquitoes breathe through the air holes in their body. Plants breathe through their tiny holes called stomata present in their leaves. So students, different living organisms, different living things have different way of breathing in. Obviously, it is mandatory for them to breathe in. Human beings breathe in the oxygen and breathe out the carbon dioxide. Anyways, they have the different way. Like human beings, if you can see in the picture, they have the nose. Whereas here in the leaves, they say that stomata is there as a part of nose. Like we human beings have nose, leaves have stomata through which they breathe in. Yes, when human beings breathe out carbon dioxide, plants breathe in the carbon dioxide and gives away our oxygen out in the air. So this is a different breathing technique. So here it is written clearly that non-living things do not breathe. Moving on to here, living things need food to grow. Food gives energy to work and move. Obviously, animals, wild animals, herbivores, carnivores, even the human beings, birds, every living thing needs food, and so do the plants. So I even explained you plants, that plants do not need to go in the search of food. Have you seen plants walking here and there in the grocery shop, in the bakery, searching for the food or buying the food? No. They make their own food in the presence of air, water and light. That means sunlight. So plants making their own food is called the process. That process is named photosynthesis. So in the plants also, for your knowledge students, let me tell you, green leaves are the one who makes the food for the plants. Then coming on to living thing feel changes. Now we feel by our sensory organs. Similarly, many animals have sensory organs like eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin to see, hear, smell, taste, touch respectively. So many animals have the same sensory organs, five main sensory organs, but exceptions are there. Here it is shown that grasshopper and similar to it is cockroach, they have the antenna to feel the changes around them. Also, like I have shown you before few minutes, that plants also feel, they also move. Like when you touch the plant, mimosa plant I showed you before, that plant, if you touch, they can feel that change and then closes itself. Similarly, if you see the sunflower will feel the change. It will move its head in the direction of sun, and so do the lotus flower. Lotus flower is our national flower. So there is a speciality that lotus flower opens up in the morning and closes at the night with the sunrise and sunset respectively. And non-living things do not feel changes at all. With this, we also saw that living things reproduce. Every living thing has different way of reproducing. Reproduce means to produce the creature of your own kind, another creature of your own kind, that is called reproduction. Some give eggs, some give the birth directly to the young ones, and so on. Plants also have the different methods of reproducing, by seeds, by the roots, by stems and etc. We can grow the plant. So that is called the reproduction method of the plant. And non-living things do not reproduce. So I hope with this, students, you understood this, the repetition of the chapter which I have already explained you in detail in the previous two parts. Now let us solve few objectives of this chapter. So here you can see that this is the exercise part, objective type questions, which is there in your textbook. So those who are having the textbook, they can solve it within the textbook, and those who are not having the textbook, nothing to worry about. You can just jot down your answers in the rough notebook. For a meantime, once you get your textbook, you can again copy the answers in your textbook. So the first question is fill in the blanks. Whenever needed, I will zoom in the picture and zoom it out. Okay. Now here you can see fill in the blanks with the correct words. So in the blanks, beside the blanks, options are given. You have to just choose the correct option and that's it. Let's get started with this. Dash, plants and animals are living things. I repeat the question. Dash, plants and animals are living things. So what do you think will be the answer for this first question? All or some? Some plants and animals are living things? No, all the plants and animals are living things, right? Because here they have only referred to plants and animals. So here the answer will be all. So I will write the answer in the same way you also have to write it down. Okay, I hope you can see the answer written here. So all the plants and animals are living things. This will be the answer. Let us move on to the second one. Question is, animals move from place to place in search of dash. Options are only food or food and shelter. Let me repeat the question for you. Please try to understand. Animals move from place to place in search of dash. Only food or food and shelter. What do you think, students, will be the correct answer? Yes, food and shelter is correct answer. See, I don't have the space here, so I cannot write such a long answer, but for you I have underlined the correct answer. Correct answer is food and shelter. For those who are writing in the textbook, it's very easy for them to write the answers here beside the blank. For those who are writing in the rough book, they can just write answer 1, answer 2, answer 3, and they can just write the answer like all, food and shelter, and so on, so that they will have the answer in the meantime. Or else, if you want to even write the question, you can again watch this lecture from the YouTube, you can pause the video, you can write the question. So these are the ways I am giving you out how you can work it out. Okay, so the next one is, dash plants make their own food. Dash plants make their own food. All or green? What will be the correct answer? Obviously, the correct answer will be green. Green plants make their own food. Like I said, green leaves, they are used, they make the food for the plants. And this process is called photosynthesis. So green is the correct answer. I hope you are writing the answer, students. Next is, dash things do not move on their own. Dash things do not move on their own. Living or non-living? So the correct answer is non-living things. They do not move on their own. They need the external force done by the living things. So non-living thing is the correct answer. And I hope that before I marked the answer, you have already recognized which is the correct answer, because we have understood the chapter twice. Once in a detail in two parts and today in brief. Moving on to the last fill in the blanks. Plants breathe through tiny holes called dash, gills or stomata. From where do plants breathe? Gills or stomata? So let us see the picture again of plants. And what is gills and what is stomata? Can you see here stomata? So this is how the plants breathe. So what will be the answer? Now answer. So the correct answer will be stomata, obviously, because stomata is an organ from which the plants breathe. Gills is for the fishes, not for the plants. Anyways, stomata is the correct answer. I hope that you are writing your answers. So I'll just repeat all the answers. Answer number 1, all. Answer number 2, food and shelter. Answer number 3, green. Answer number 4, non-living. Answer number 5, stomata. I hope that you have done all these answers properly, either in your textbook or in your rough notebook. For those who were writing in the rough notebook, I hope they have written the heading properly, fill in the blanks, FB, chapter number, date. These all things should be mentioned. Also, my dear students, those who are even writing in the rough notebook, make sure that you write with a neat and clean handwriting. And for the students who are writing in the textbook itself, please write today's date here, so that when you click the photograph of this work and when you send it to the teachers, we can just note down that on which date you have done this. Now students, moving on to match the following. So let us match the following columns. Column A and column B. Now let us first read all the words properly. Birds, plant, cockroach, food. Whereas on the column B side, air holes, energy to work, wings, seed. Now you need to compare both the sides. Can you match birds with the air holes? Can you match it with the energy to work? Can you match it with the wings? Yes, you can match the bird with wings. So birds should be matched with the wings, because birds have got wings to fly. This is how the birds move. If you remember, living things move, in that topic, birds move with their wings. Now, how can you match the plant? Air holes, energy to work, or seed? So, you all know that the plants reproduce either by the roots, by stems, or by seeds. So, plants we can match with the seeds, because no other match is as perfect as plant seed. Now students, moving on to next, cockroach. Can you match it with the energy to work? Obviously not. So only the remaining option is air holes. And the last one, obviously food with energy to work, because only when you eat food, you will get energy to work. Not only you, like it was written, truly written, that all living things need food for to grow and for the energy to work. So I hope students you have matched all the columns properly. I will repeat the answers. For those who are writing in the rough book, they can just directly write birds equals to wings, plant equal to seed, cockroach equals to air hole, food equals to energy to work. I will repeat so that the one who are writing in the rough book, they will get the time to complete it. And for those who are doing in the textbook, please make sure you match the pairs properly. If you are drawing the line like this, use your scale. So birds have wings, plant are grown with the seed, cockroaches have the air holes obviously to breathe, food gives us energy to work. So students, that is the end of today's lecture. The remaining objectives and subjective will be given to you in the next lecture. I hope that you enjoyed the lecture. Also, you have revised all the topics. You have even solved few of your queries you were having. Still, if you have a query, you are free to call me. So, with this, our fill in the blanks and match the columns are over. I have already given you keywords. If you remember, I will show it to you again. These keywords I already asked you to write in the previous lecture. Not only that, but also I have given you different points in the previous to previous lecture. So I hope you have completed all this work properly in your book. With this students, I end my lecture now. Thanks for watching the lecture. Please keep sending the work to your teachers. Take care of yourselves, of your family members. Wash your hands 10 times in a day. Wear your masks. Don't go out unnecessarily. Take care. Goodbye.